Welcome back to my channel. I am Christy of Christopher Art Studio and Workshops, currently located in Mexico, Chapala, Jalisco, Mexico. And today I'm gonna show you how I painted this little painting of actually San Miguel de Allende. San Miguel de Allende is a little town in the central Mexico, in the state of Guanajuato. It's a mountain town, so it has a lot of character. And this painting, it's a painting of the main church seeing from a distance. I have painted this view, I don't know, maybe 50 times, and have sold all the paintings I've done, and I just love this view. It's very characteristic of San Miguel, characteristic of Mexico in general, and includes all the elements that you will find in pretty much any mountain town. Looking from the top of the street, looking down, you see the church in the distance. And the church in San Miguel de Allende has a very characteristic shape, very recognizable shape if you have ever been there, or if you want to Google it to see how it looks. It's very unique. Out of all the paintings I've painted with this view, I still have one. The last one I have, it's a pretty big painting. It's 1 meter and 20 centimeters by 80 centimeters in width. I am painting with acrylic paints, and they are biodegradable paints. I like to use materials that are not hurting the environment. We as painters sometimes feel that we are contributing too much to the pollution of the environment. The little tray that you see that I'm using, they're trays that I recycle from buying meat or buying potato patties or things like this. Wash them really good and use them. You've seen me cleaning the palette knife. I use a felt fabric to clean the palette knife, so I don't use paper towels. I know many people are used to using paper towels, and they, I don't know through how many rolls of paper towels they go for a painting, according to the size of the painting. I think it's really a waste when I can use the felt, or I can use you can use an old shirt or something like this, and you can use it a lot of times without even washing it, because then you are using water to clean it. I am using bright colors, as you see, lots of the secondary colors. The blue that I am using from the bottle, it's a tint of a ultramarine blue. And I've been using some terracotta. I did the initial sketch with terracotta. Sometimes I sketch with white. Sometimes I sketch with whatever paint I have left in the palette from a previous painting. I like to use palette knife. I use these plastic palette knives. Oh, I start using them probably about 5-6 years ago, when I start teaching palette knife, including palette knife in the classes that I am giving. Before, I used to use metal palette knife for my own paintings. And I love metal palette knife. I like the pointy shape. And now I'm pretty much using the same material that I give to the students when they take a class with me in person here in Mexico. I prefer to demonstrate with the same materials that the student is gonna use. When you take a workshop in Mexico, I prefer that you use the materials that I offer, because it's a certain palette, the brightness of the colors, Mexican paints, and they are mixed for the palette of color here in Mexico. A lot of times when people come with their own palette, with their own paints, the painting looks darker, more like North America. I am adding this view that I'm painting has a building forward and looking down the street, and from this window, the building has a window, and down this window comes a huge plant, and probably comes from over a wall and then climbs towards the window and then goes down the wall. I've taken a photo of this view, and later on I know that somebody bought this house that's forward and they painted it gray. I'm working forward into the painting. I am going from the palette knife to brush, because when I work with brush I can implement detail. I can do things that are a little more specific. And I like to work with palette knife. I love palette knife. Actually, I can do an entire painting in palette knife. Probably I will do a demonstration of how to paint entirely with palette knife. Please subscribe to my channel and like this video, and let me know if you would like to see a demonstration or painting done entirely in palette knife and see how it can be used. If you are a beginner or an intermediate painter, I suggest that you take your acrylics or oils, all the brushes you have, and practice with the brush. See how many different marks you can create with the same brush. I usually use 3-4 brushes in painting a painting, but I can pretty much use one single brush for an entire painting. I love flat brushes. Those brushes that I use are synthetic brushes. I like these brushes because they are very versatile and they last a long time. You do have to take care of them, make sure that you don't let them dry out with the paint. You have to go through the unpleasant process of trying to save them, and sometimes you can save them, sometimes you don't. If you are a painter, or if you are someone who's just starting out, I would love if you leave me comments down below and let me know what you like to paint, what you would like to learn how to paint, or see a demonstration. I don't paint animals, I don't paint birds, but I certainly can give it a shot. I also have videos on Skillshare. Skillshare is a platform with lots of videos. And at this moment I have, I don't know, 3 or 4 videos. Probably by the time you watch these videos, who knows, in 2 months or 2 years, I'm gonna have more videos on Skillshare. I'm gonna put a link below so you can have a free, can sign up for 2 free weeks, and you can watch my videos where I explain how to do things, what is my thinking process, what is the structure behind a sketch, and later behind the painting. If you like to take your time and you like to have personalized instruction, you can contact me below also, or you can send me an email and we can schedule Zoom class. The Zoom classes I offer are private classes. I prefer to personalize what I teach. If you want a workshop with other people and to learn in a group, you can take a 5 days workshop in Mexico. You can check out my website, or you can check out my Facebook, Cristi Fair Art. You can see what else I am offering at the time. So this is the 4th brush pretty much that I'm using. This is a number 1, I think, brush. And I'm adding some details. When I paint, I stand back a lot and I look into how to balance color, where I need to add shadow, lights, if the perspective of what I'm doing looks credible. When I paint something for the first time or second or 10th time, I use a reference photo. I start with the reference photo and I start with the sketch. And at some point, I just move away from the photo and balance color. That's pretty much my goal. I am an expressionist painter. And I like to paint landscape and urban landscape. So pretty much my goal in any painting or even a sketch is to capture how I felt in the moment. In the moment I took the photo, or in the moment I was there on the top of this street looking down. It's probably beginning of summer because I'm putting a lot of purple trees, purple plants. They are called jacarandas. I am not sure how you call them in English, but they are beautiful purple trees. If you have traveled to Mexico, probably you are familiar with them. I'm adding some details here forward. So the more details I have in the front of the painting, in the first plane of the painting, the more depth the painting will have. Again, if you got so far into the video, I appreciate if you would subscribe, like the video. Also, if you would share it with friends or on your Facebook page, would be awesome. I am trying to build my channel and it's moving up slowly. Occasionally, I resketch in top of the painting just to remember what's what. If you have never been to Mexico, I have many students that come for the very first time to Mexico to take a workshop with us. And I'm saying us because Fernando Gonzalez and myself, Cristiana Mar, we are the Christopher R. Studio. We both sometimes teach together, sometimes independently.